This Christmas is unlike others in recent memory, isn't it? Instead of gathering families together to celebrate the birth of Jesus, we are encouraging folks to avoid large indoor gatherings. Instead of traveling to one's grandmother's house, we are asked to stay home to celebrate quietly. We aren't even able to worship together in person this Christmas. We know this is being asked of us in order to keep ourselves and others safe from the coronavirus. But still, let's acknowledge that it's hard. And then let's think about a quiet Christmas. The Christmas story is easily and quickly told. Many Christmas hymns do it in a few verses. The Gospel of Luke tells it in just 20 verses. After all, it's just a story of a young woman and her husband separated from their families as she is due to give birth to their first child. Their shelter is a cave or a room shared with animals. They have only each other and the meager supplies they carried with them. And yet, it's in this simple place that glory enters human history. This is where heaven touches earth and God takes human form. Mary's labor brings forth a babe, fully human and fully divine. A miracle, hard to comprehend, but one that will change the world. Yes, it's a simple story, which may be why the magnitude of what it means often overwhelms and eludes us. This Christmas, this quiet Christmas, offers us a chance to hold that simple story close. It gives us a space in which to contemplate the courage of Mary, the faithfulness of Joseph, and the vulnerability of God as a human baby. This quiet Christmas gives us time to focus on love, love incarnate, and love for one another. Love will give us the patience and grace we will need with one another to get through the next weeks and months until the vaccine is widely available. Love will fill this quiet time with hope. It was true that first Christmas, and it's true now. So stay safe and have a Merry Christmas and a healthy, happy New Year.